Welcome back, everyone. Welcome to the nice, hilly natures of Draugen. I am Nevercraven, and let's continue on searching for the truth. Because that's basically what we're doing here. We're trying to figure out what happened to Betty and why there is no one, as far as we know, living on this island at this moment. So let's see if we can find some more, let's say, evidence or maybe anything resembling life, because we haven't even seen animals so far as I know. The only thing we've seen is a shadow at night looking through the window, and I keep saying it, but I'm saying it's a weeping angel, but we have to continue on to see what that actually is.
A boat! Teddy! Hot dog! This is our ticket out of here!
Not without Betty. Besides, the wood's rotted through. This boat isn't seaworthy. It's curious. The state of the boats. It's like they stopped taking care of them.
Seems short-sighted. How would they fish? Or get anywhere at all?
To be honest, we read last time that all the kids died in the village. And I think that has a lot to do with why they didn't take care of them. Now, the bigger question is, what did they do after that? Did the town just cease to exist or something? Is that the reason why there's nobody here? Like I said, intriguing story. We need more information. We need more facts. We need more intel. Well, we did learn last time that Draugen is basically dragons. I think a lot of people probably knew that when they saw it, but overall, I'm not that smart. So I just, in the last episode, really learned that. Ooh, what's this?
What's this?
Remnants of the mining operation.
What, mine?
Remember, I told you yesterday. There was a mine here, but it closed down 20 years ago.
I know, Edward. I was just checking for a sense of humor. Still nowhere to be found.
Till Minna Om. It's a memorial. Three men died when the mine collapsed in 1902. Georg Hattestad, Niels Frambu, Arne Fretland.
See, this is what working a regular job. Did you say Fretland?
The younger brother who was mentioned in the article. He was just 19.
How long had he been working in the mine? That's too young for a dirty job like digging into rock.
We're in the real world, Lissie. Most teeners don't have the luxury to idle away their days with games and witty repartee.
Ouch.
Yes, it was literally a jab at how she's acting and reacting. he got a little bit of a wit in him, that Teddy.
The newspaper said the accident forced the mine to shut down.
What does any of this have to do with us?
I still don't know why Elizabeth came here.
And you think it has something to do with this mine?
Or with what it did to the village, maybe.
Like I said, still more to figure out. There are a lot of broken boats here, that's the thing. Alright, not seeing any markers for us to go and check.
Where do these tracks lead?
To the mine, where else would they go?
I don't know. A castle up in the mountains? Where the frost giants live? And this is how they receive their monthly offering of meat from the villagers. Goat, I hope.
Overgrown, so more signs that there hasn't been anything going on here for the last 2 years. Or so it seems.
What did they use this for?
Bringing the ore down from the mine before it was loaded onto boats.
So, diamonds? Gold? Or just boring old silver?
Iron ore.
Or what?
Rock, which contains iron deposits.
I know,
deposits
that... Okay, Edward. I don't understand why they just leave this here. Like an altar to adversity. It's creepy.
Rustic superstition. Perhaps they believed it'd attract bad luck if they moved it.
Yeah, or something else happened to stop the entire village in their tracks. I still believe there's something more going on than just all the deaths. I think something else happened after that. Woo! New drawer space. Oh, that's a beautiful one with a nice little quaint waterfall. I like the looks of this game, especially the surroundings. It really gives that nice and naturey feel to it. And then hopefully we have one scene that's already been like that. Hopefully we're gonna get some more of those. And that's the tense moments, and the darkness, the shades, the shadows, the nighttime. I hope there's gonna be a lot more of those, because those two offsets to one another. Can be a really amazing thing to tell a mystery story. Oh, the waterfall is on there. I thought it would be more center stage than this. Oh. Still like the drawings. Because I think, like I said in another episode, I think those are the collectibles of this game. So we're going to do our utmost, our best to see if we can find all of them. And of course, if we do find all of them, I will note it in the playlist.
Cool. Want to jump the gate and explore what's on the other side?
Trespassing. Yeah, I don't think he cares for danger. It's more the trespassing thing.
The sign says no trespassing for a reason.
Come on! There may be trolls, or at least more houses. Where's your sense of adventure, old sport? Don't you want to see where these tracks go?
They lead to the old mine, and no. I've had enough adventure on this side of the fence. Besides, they wrote no trespassing for a reason.
You're such a terrible bore, Teddy Bear. I'll wager 1,000 clams you'll jump this gate at some point, if you believe Betty's on the other side.
True.
Fretland. Who are these traitors he refers to?
The people close to mine.
Look everywhere.
There really doesn't seem to be anyone around.
Maybe we miss something. An important clue. How about the generator? We haven't been inside yet.
It looked deserted, but worth another look, I guess.
Okay, so she's saying there might be more to the general store. There was an open window, but we had no indication or ability to click on that open window to get in there. So maybe now that they're saying there isn't anything more, we are now getting the possibility to find it.
And they can't.
Oh, what did you find anything? Anyway. I thought she was gonna say something very intriguing, but she just suddenly stopped. What about if people couldn't speak? It would be a great source for a thriller. Or a mystery novel. Ah, more drawing. Yeah, and these drawing places also give us a little bit of time to rest, to get rid of a little bit of exhaustion, because this guy, he's not the most healthy guy, or the game just portrays him as old, I don't know yet, but they say he gets exhausted really fast. Let's see what the drawing drew for us. This one I like. The play of shades, the drop of the pencil. Really nice. I think this goes up towards the house we came from. Yeah, I'm gonna run a little bit because I think there's also another play. What's this? A milk can. Fine. This bench would have been also a nice place to stand if there was anything worth drawing. Oh, this has so many places to explore. Ah, is that another drawing place? We're finding a lot of drawer places this time, but I think it's a good thing, because, like I said, if you find all of them, we can also say this is a playthrough. Ooh! He's goating us. Okay, he was not that funny, but thanks. Alright. Very specific. If the goat wasn't there, would we be able to draw it or not? Let's check it out. Yeah, he's getting up, I know. Goatee! Thank you. Well done. Onwards to the next drawing of excellence. Yeah, that is the house. Can we get up this hill? I doubted that as well. Alright, so at least this stroll out from the beaten path gave us another drawing place. I love it. So let's get down once more, and we're gonna go through the side area a little bit just to see if there is another place to draw inspiration from. Let's just name it like that. Yeah, and that window. I think that's gonna be our way in. Alright, we found something living. And it looked like it's trying to get in. Hey, Raven. Are you trying to help us and the other ravens figuring out this mystery? Together we can make it, I know it.
Lissie, come here. It's Betty's hat. She was here. She could still be in there. Betty? Betty!
Are you sure, Edward? I mean, it's just a hat. Is it even a hat?
I know my sister's hat, Lissie. I have to get inside.
What about the breaking and entering part?
I could care less what they call it.
She called it. As soon as Betty's involved, he doesn't care about anything but finding out the truth, finding her. Alright, we already know where the window is, so let's get in there.
Here's an open window.
You seem eager to break the law. I approve.
Use some force.
It won't budge.
Nah, don't be a milquetoast.
Well, it's stuck.
Attaboy, Teddy. You can do this.
You could help. Or are you not able to? Hmm?
I can't believe I'm actually breaking. Whoops-a-daisy.
Oh my, Teddy. You're such a sap.
Oh, it's gotta be a kitchen or something, because what else would there be hanging on the ceiling? Come on, get up. Oh, of course, it's a general store, so there can be things on the ceiling just as what to sell.
World traveler, cat burglar.
A cat burglar would, by definition, enter a building on a higher floor.
The state of this place.
Oh, Betty.
Edward.
I hope you weren't here when...
Is this... blood?
Not necessarily human blood.
Well, that's all right, then. What does it say? Barn murder? Someone murdered a barn?
Barn means child, and mortar, that's...
Child murder. Edward, they murdered a child?
Someone thought so.
Probably the same someone who vandalized the store.
I'm not sure how I feel about being in here.
Don't be ridiculous. We're all alone. What else do you suggest we do?
Clean the place up, because this looks really bad. Okay, let's unlock this. That way we can just go outside when we're done. Don't need to climb out of windows and make us look even more suspicious if someone is alive on this island and sees us getting out of there.
It's the same photograph as in the farmhouse.
Johan's gone. At least, I assume he's the one who's been... Snip!
Frederick clearly did not want anything to do with his twin brother.
Okay, so he didn't go... willingly away from the mine, or maybe think he has something to do with the destruction of the mine because he went away just before it collapsed. Oh, it is intriguing. Okay. More data. No, let's go to the back place, because I think in the front place where the head was, and I want to go there last. I want to explore everything first. Utah Drift.
Out of order.
Ah, okay.
Perhaps there wasn't much demand for it anymore. Out of order.
Why hasn't it been fixed?
Perhaps there wasn't much demand for it anymore. These were never sent.
How long have they been piling up?
I received Mrs. Fretland's letter in June, and they received my letter from July.
A couple of months. Perhaps the world forgot about Grovik.
Our Grovik forgot about the world.
S. O. S.
Not creepy at all.
Oh boy. If only this thing worked. We could order a boat to come get us. Or, even better, order some hot grub.
Simon and Ruth. Are they married?
What are you doing?
Looking for keys.
Your life of crime continues.
Hey, if you said A, you might as well say B.
There's a note.
Is it written in Viking runes? What does it say?
It's from Simon. Casa. I don't know what that word means.
The register? Because casa is basically the Dutch word for it. So maybe that's it?
Jij put it means I put. Nurkel is key.
He put the key in the casa?
Casa. I wish I had my dictionary. The note's addressed to his father.
So the key was moved. But where to?
Somewhere safer. Or more convenient.
Can we really trust your translations? You only started studying a month ago.
I spent the summer reading. And I had a lot of free time on the ocean voyage.
Come on, how much could you possibly pick up in a few months?
You know my mind, it's a sponge.
Well, at least my being Dutch gave us a little bit of an edge in this game, for once. I'm pretty sure it's not gonna happen again. Come on, open up.
Casa.
See? So that's what it means. Cash register.
Told ya. Probably Scandinavian and Dutch have some similar words. Isn't that strange? It does happen over different languages. Alright, so, open.
You're a genuine gangster now, old fruit. Don't worry. If you get busted, I'll come visit you in the big house.
Ah, kronen. So basically cash. Key or cash. No. Like I said, we are breaking in, but we are still good people, so we're just gonna go for the key.
Wasn't there supposed to be a key?
Here it is.
Yeah, I think even if we would pick the cat, I don't think he will grab it.
Traitors.
What did they do to him?
Cross him in some way. Why else keep a list of undesirables?
No. Right word. Shit list. Stay with it, man. Stay with it. Show your true colors. You know it. You know you want to. No. Last thing, always last thing. Bingo. Yeah, a little bit on the nose, isn't it, game?
It is her hat.
Teddy, I'm not
Betty
sure that's...
Betty was here, and not long ago.
Okay, but... But if that is her hat, what's it doing in a locked storeroom?
Another breadcrumb.
That's not an answer.
I know for sure she was here. That's what matters.
You know best, Edward. So, what now? If this is a breadcrumb, where's the next one?
There must be a reason her hat's in this room.
Yeah, there was a letter beneath it, but I think more surprising is why are we finding clothing pieces from exactly the same one that's in the picture? Or she doesn't have any different kind of dresses, and if you know your women, that can totally not be true. Or there is something else more supernatural to this. Which I already thought from the first episode we did here. But let's continue on.
What's that?
A handwritten note.
Not blind. What does it say, you silly goose?
It's hard to read. I'm not sure my translation will be... Johan, you... Nectar. Refuse. You refuse to speak to me, so I write this letter instead. It's from Frederick Fretland to his brother. Simon did not... Bloody hell. Simon did not murder your Ruth. He was fond of his cousin.
Ruth? Ruth is the daughter of Anna and Johan, which means... the little girl in the photograph at the farmhouse. Oh, Edward... the Fretland girl was murdered. This is simply awful.
Simon was working at the farm while I tended to the store. I would have seen him had he passed on the way up to the cliffs.
They thought Simon killed Ruth. His own cousin.
Ruth was... what's that word? Playing. Ruth was always playing on the rocks below the church. She must have fallen by accident. The note ends there. Frederick never finished it. And Johan never read it. Not that it would have made a difference. If Johan thought...
the mob showed up for Simon. His father would have tried to protect him.
September 17th. You would have been here, Betty.
Rocks below the church. Isn't the church right above us? Edward, come look at this! That's the cliff! Right there! The one in the note? I bet you a million clams.
Where?
See for yourself.
Okay, so... the plot thickens. The kid dies, but they didn't say that all the kids in the village died. But maybe she was the only kid in the village. Alright, alright.
I guess that could be where...
let's check it out!
No, Lissie, wait.
Yeah, but she's right. We need to check out... again, silently moving from one room to the other. Like I said, I've been thinking from the first thing, and this is a theory, so... this is not a spoiler, because I haven't played this yet. But I get a feeling that... Alice may not be real. But it could also be just game mechanics. But it's so strange because, like I said, she suddenly is missing during the night. She comes by us from the back. We don't hear her or anything. Right now she moves from one room to the other without using the doors or anything like that. Small things that can all be explained by they didn't program it in the game or something. But it could also be a hint that she might not be real. But like, it's a theory, so let's just continue on the game and see if we can find anything to disprove that or anything. Let's see. Can we go out of the window, or does the game want us to go through the front door? Once a criminal, always a criminal. Okay, where are you?
Teddy, up here.
Is she already? Again.
I found it, Teddy. The cliff. I'm standing right below it.
What are you doing? This doesn't concern us.
The little girl died.
up here, Edward Harden, right this minute.
So you want me to walk all over it? Come on. Do you know how much of a effort this gonna be from my side? What do you expect me to do?
It's an easy climb.
This looks very dangerous.
Oh, you're a big boy. Start acting like it. Not Mount Everest.
I don't know about this. Whoops-a-daisy.
Oh, come on. A little bit more manly coming, like, damn you rocks. That would be a lot better. Oops, whoops-a-daisy. Teddy-ho, and all that. Alright. Let's see what she wants from us up here. Grave.
What is this?
Where little Ruth died.
You're being morbid. And this is a distraction. I'm here for Betty, not because some girl
Edward,
got herself.
You insensitive brute. You're like the Tin Woodman, no heart. You've grown cold and mean in that horrid study of yours. With only books and bugs to keep you company for years and years and years. There are other people in this world, you know. It's not all about you. You're going to do this. If not for Ruth, then for us. We're going to figure out what happened to the poor girl. Together.
Yeah, I think we also need to know, because where is everyone? It has to be something with it, because they already said that that mob mentality ruled and probably went after Johan was the day that Betty was here. So one thing might lead to another. So it's not a totally invalid proposition to try and figure out what went on here. Alright, let's check it out. Flowers.
That's been here a while.
Didn't you say it happened over a month ago?
You'd think her family would have replaced it with fresh flowers.
Unless, they ain't here anymore. Alright. Thumbnail, yeah. Alright, let's go and see if we can get a little bit higher. We should be around the church. What do you think?
Teddy, where are you going?
Okay, so they don't want me to go to the church as yet. Tricky, tricky little game.
What are you doing? Is that blood?
The girl could have hit her head on that rock. There would have been plenty of blood.
That's awful. I think there's something behind it. Can you move the rock aside?
Okay, so it's not that we weren't allowed to the church, it's that we didn't see everything yet. So the game wants, look more, there is more.
It must be Ruth's.
Where's the head?
Maybe the killer also decapitates dolls.
Hold on. This pin. This is old. Very old. Looks like something from the Viking era.
We are in the land of Vikings.
This could be 1,000 years old. It does not belong in a child's doll.
Who cares? Ruth is dead and you're obsessing about a rusty old pin? Let's go further up. Maybe we'll find more clues. Come on, old sport. It's not far.
Can you wait just 1 minute so that I can catch my breath?
Huh. I was more thinking about that, catching your breath.
Path, Betty?
Catch that pin. Oh, it's thousands of years. It's money. Goodness. Yeah, like I said, it is still a beautiful environment. Alright, let's go up and see what we can find there. We're just a little bit ahead of the curve, apparently. I think he's gonna pass out again. Probably need a resting rock somewhere.
You can see clear beyond the edge of the world. You're right. It is awfully chilly.
One.
Second. Teddy bear. We need to take you out walking more often.
So, the girl fell from up here.
Was pushed, you mean. Can you see where she fell? Can you see where she fell?
Certainly high enough to kill a child.
If I had to go, this would be the way to do it. Soaring through the air like a bird.
And landing like a rock. If she fell headfirst on that rock, she'd have died instantly.
Edward! Honestly.
You wanted to learn more. This is you learning more. She hit her head and fell into the bush where I found her doll. Happy now, Alice?
I'm not. What was she doing up here in the first place?
Playing? She was a child. Children play in dangerous places.
There must be more to it. Let's find out where this path leads.
No, absolutely not. I don't have time for this nonsense. We're running out of daylight, and Betty's still... You're still out there.
Yes, yes, he is. But, like he said, he needed the time to rest, so we are resting right now. We're going to end the episode right here. Alright, so, we're learning more and more that Teddy can be a criminal if it's motivated well enough. Basically, if it's about Betty, he'll do any crime possible to get near there. And we found out a little bit more about the dying child, little things surrounding it. The mystery is thickening right up nicely, so next time we're gonna explore some more, go to the church, our final item on the list of three places we need to check, and let's see what's going on there. And hopefully at the second night on this island, maybe we'll see some more ghostly evidence, maybe. But that's for next time. So, until next time, I wish you all a great night, morning, day, wherever you are. Till next time, my ravens. Bye-bye.